Greetings, folks, and welcome to this lovely small town of Eastend, Saskatchewan. We're going to get to the car show part of this as soon as possible, but first we're going to do a little bit of a walk around and see what we can see in this little, really nice town, I gotta say. We'll start here by the elevators. We'll go down towards the main drag, go up said main drag, and then back down towards in the direction we are now. Let's just put it that way. You'll have to excuse me, guys. It's 36 degrees and my brain is melting. That's about 95 degrees in freedom units for those of you down south. So we're just gonna get started with the elevator here and work our way around. I'll try to show you as much of the town as possible. And I hope you can hear me because quite frankly, I didn't want to mess with any extra audio gear today, so you're hearing whatever is coming off the Action 3 right now. So I think this is the older of the two elevators. It's the big white one, which used to be the big burgundy one. And we're just going to work our way towards the other one, which you can probably see right now, that green one right there. The green one used to be the big orange one, way back when. We don't need to be on the street right now, so we'll just cross the parking lot. Right over here is Public Works. And you can probably see some really awesome trains in the shot right now, at least I hope you can. Don't know if this camera is going to be shutting down or not, but so far it's working. We'll talk about those trains more in a second or five or 10 or 20. Once my brain gets finished melting into a little puddle of goo. This town has about 650 people living in it, so far. At least I think as of the last census. Next major town to the west, or not to the west, the east, is Shaunavon with about 1,800 people. Next major town to the west is Consul with 100 people, about. So, this is about the end of civilization until you get to either Maple Creek or Shaunavon or Haver in Montana. Because once you cross the border into Alberta, there is nothing, 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 nothing all the way almost to the mountains. Which can be good if you're into that kind of thing. Which I am some days. Not today, though. Yes, those trains are awesome. We'll get to those in due time. We are heading that way anyway. Well, there's a cool old car over there. Not sure what kind. I like cars, but I'm not as into them as most people are. Let's put it that way. Long as I have a nice one, I'm happy. I don't need to go looking for any others. And there's your big green elevator right there. These elevators are both still in use. Fairly active little town, this one. So we might as well go over to those trains now and talk about them a little bit. These trains are going to be part of Eastend Scenic Rail Tours. They're going to be used. The story behind that is a collector from the Battlefords area bought all these trains and he wants to do something with them, so he chose Eastend as his base of operations for that. And we're all hoping these trains get going sometime, maybe later this year, but we'll see how things go with that. There's going to be all sorts of cool stuff attached to these trains, we hope. Can't wait to see what he does with those. Right now I'm just trying to walk along here, trying not to break my ankle in a gopher hole or something. And the hope is, when he does get these trains going, I'll be able to make a video about them in greater detail. Like maybe from the inside. That'd be cool. I believe he's got most of these all serviced now and mostly working, but I could be wrong. Don't quote me on that. Okay, so we've reached the front of the trains. You can see that CP Rail caboose over there. That's part of the whole experience. These trains really are something special. I'm glad he picked Eastend as a home base for his, or showcasing his collection. But let's continue on. We got stuff to shoot. So at one time, I believe Eastend used to have four grain elevators. You just saw two of them. The other two were up yonder. Obviously not there anymore. But we'll continue on here, past the brand new emergency medical building. That's where all the ambulances go and fire trucks. We're getting to the cars. Don't worry. I saw them driving to town, so I know they're there. Over yonder, you've got a brand new co-op building going up. Not finished yet. That'll be gas station and probably convenience store. Used to be a lumber yard right next to it, but recently demolished. Oh Lord, why did I have to do this on a 36 degree day? I am sweating like you would not believe. All right, I'll show you some more stuff here. This is the rink and curling arena. Very large complex, still being used. There's not much else down that street but residential. But there is something over there in that building. Not exactly sure what it is. I'm too hot to go over and look. And right here, this used to be the old co-op store. It's now Crazy Cowboys Electrical Contractors. And they also operate a car repair shop on the other end of town, which we're not going to be seeing because it's too darn hot for me to do that. You got your hair oasis there and Moose's Outfitting for all your outdoorsy stuff. There's Stenerson Auto Parts, the best for tires. Also does a few minor vehicular repairs. Let's go to the other side of the street. There's shade over there. This here used to be a Rexall drugstore. Closed a while ago, never reopened. Everybody in town misses it, I think. This town is just big enough to notice an absence like that. Across the street, you've got your Government of Canada building with the post office built into it. And IG Wealth Management next to it. And the only bank in town, which is the Innovation Credit Union. And there is still a grocery store happening right here. So the town isn't entirely without a grocery store. Next to it, you've got an art gallery for the word doctor. And next to that is a private residence that used to be the Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, I do believe. We're gonna go this way, because the other end of town does have some stuff like the United Church and the Wallace Stegner House, but there's really not that much there. There's a car wash down that way too, if you can ever catch it working. Cypress Hotel, one of two places you can stay in town. The other one is clearer that direction. And there's the municipal office building there, along with Eastend agencies where you can get your car license done. And I'm gonna make you wait a little bit longer. Let's go across the street here. I can see the cars from here. They're parked in front of, well, you'll see. Cypress Hotel here is one of at least two good places to get a burger. Highly recommend them. The other being the clubhouse, which is down the other street here. It's just that way. The golf clubhouse is, anyway. I hope you can understand half the things I'm talking about, because brain is fried. That's an apartment building right there. Can't remember what this used to be. It used to be something. And this is Charlie's Lunch here. been closed a while. You can't get lunch there anymore, but it's a private art gallery now. Kind of, sort of, in a way. I know the people working there. They're awesome. Or who own it, I mean. Alright, before we go look at those awesome cars, which there are more arriving every second, it seems like, I'll just tell you a bit about the businesses across the street there. Way over that way, you've got the Eastend Historical Museum. It's a fairly decent-sized complex, from what you can tell from this angle. But the old Pastime Theater used to be where that newish brown building is right there. I've got shots of it when they were demolishing that building. It wasn't safe, so they had to take it down. Anyway, there's another small business right next to that, and then over yonder you see another big brick building. That used to be the Bank of Montreal. Next to that you've got Jack's Cafe, the other decent place to get a burger, among other things. Doctor's office behind this truck here. And then Cranky's Beer, Wine, and Spirits, if you're craving such things. Alright, it's car time. I apologize if I cut this a little short on you, but I gotta go find some ice cream as soon as possible, so I hope I don't rush this through too quickly for y'all. So we're just gonna go down the line here and have a look, see what we got here. Nice old truck here. I don't know trucks, so yeah, I don't know exactly what that is. I do know it's a Ford. Kind of looks like the one my grandpa had. That's a nice Chevy, but that's a much nicer Chevy, I gotta say. I've never been a Corvette guy, but I kind of think I need to change that. Oh, now here we go. My grandma had one of these. Still kind of miss that car. It was gray. And it was awesome. I should get another one. Anyhow, sorry to do this to you guys, but that's going to take care of the car show part of this. I am melting down and I want to go get some ice cream. Okay, so I guess we can call this the day that my Action 3 overheated for the first time ever. And it looks like it's about to do it again, so we'll keep this short. You've got your Horizon and Well Tracks there, you've got your old fire hall there, no longer being used. and you've got your Eastend convenience store right there. And I happen to know that that business is up for sale if you want to have a money-making opportunity. So right next to that is the Catholic Church, and I'm going to stop filming right now and I'm going to go into the yonder store and get some ice cream right now. But I'm going to shout out one more business first. You've got your an awesome thrift store down the street there that you got to check out. It's in a really old house. You'll love it. If I can cross the street, I'll show it to you maybe. Camera's still working somehow. But yeah, the thrift shop is the knick-knack shop in that blue house right there. It was abandoned for a long time, but now it's got an awesome thrift store in it. So yeah, time for me to go get that ice cream. See you guys in the next video. Take care.